So hey everybody, welcome back to another SUPboarder video. Thanks for tuning in and watching this. This is the SUPboarder review of the Thurso Surf Expedition Touring Board, the 138. They had this board last year, but it has changed a fair amount with its graphics, the construction of the board. So there is some big improvements that Thurso Surf have put into this board this year. If you're unaware of Thurso Surf, they've been going in the market for a few years now. They're getting a lot of people on the water all around the world. Last year we did the Water Walker range of boards, which is very much their all-round range of boards. This board is the slightly longer, slightly thinner board designed to get you paddling that much further, get you covering that much more ground. But as I said, you could still get into paddleboarding on this, especially if you're a certain weight. We're going to go over who this board will best suit, and we're also going to go over pros and cons and all that sort of stuff and what it's like to paddle on the water as well, and going over a bit about the brand, the warranties you get, the environmental credibilities of the brand and all that sort of stuff, enough that hopefully you can make a good judgment if this board is right for you. So some more specifications for this board. The board's 11'6" long, 30 wide, 6 inches thick. When we weighed this board, it weighs 12.28 kilograms, and you can buy this as a complete package with a carbon shaft nylon blade, a good triple action sort of double cylinder pump and bag. Keeping the layout of this review video very much like we do all our inflatable paddleboard reviews, when you go to carry your board to the beach, you get a nice good quality wheelie bag, but it's really well padded around the shoulder straps, so you've got a waist buckle strap. There's a lot that will happily enable you to carry this board a fairly long distance. And also this year, I will note right now that these boards are lighter than the previous boards that we tested. They were sitting up around sort of 14 kilos, which is a fairly heavy board, and that was one of the complaints from last year's review when we reviewed these boards. This board is much lighter, so carrying the board on your back in that backpack really isn't a problem. You're going to be able to carry it moderate sort of long distances. So if you're getting more into that touring exploration thing, as this board is sort of set up for, you're going to be able to portage, carry your board on your back when you're not paddling it fairly easily. When it comes to pumping this board up, you still get the good quality Thurso Surf sort of triple action pump like they had last year. It's a little different this year, the way that the switching mechanism on the back is concerned, but it still works in the same way. You have three different settings, so you can get a load of volume in the board. Then when the pumping gets hard, you can reduce the volume, and then you can work on being able to get higher pressure up in the end. This does get the air in the board really quickly, and it's nice to see it come with a package like this. Just like last year, you've got removable hand pegs, so you can untie that to make the pump narrower. The foot pegs all fold in, so that's really neat as well. And again, if you're touring, if you're packing, carrying your board longer distances, having a more compact pump that fits into a smaller space is a much more handy thing. So a nice good quality pump. It's not the lightest of pumps, so if you are thinking of taking it a long journey and weight is really crucial, you're probably going to try and opt for a lighter base pump. But this is a really nice pump to generally take for most of your paddling sessions. It easily gets the amount of air into this board. The recommended PSI for this board is 12 to 15 PSI, but it can also take up to 20 PSI as well. We'll talk about the deflection test and how bendy it is in a minute. The next thing you have to put together is your three-piece paddle, just like last year. Very similar paddle, carbon shaft, nylon blade. The advantage of having that is you haven't got to worry about your paddle too much. If you knock it on the rocks, if you push yourself in the shallows along, having this nylon blade is very hard wearing. It's not the most sort of hydrodynamic shape. It doesn't allow you to paddle really fast or really effectively. It's a basic entry level paddle blade shape, but it is acceptable definitely as the package. And it's nice that you've got this carbon shaft, so then when you're paddling in the water, you get that stiffness, you get that reactiveness that the paddle is going to give you back to your paddle stroke. So basically, if you have a glass fiber or a aluminium shaft of a paddle, basically it will bend a lot more, and that way you're wasting energy putting it into the bending of the shaft instead of basically pulling you further forward through the water. But anyway, the paddle, it's nice and easy, goes together, three-piece clip system with a push pin system, all seems to work nice and easy. You will need to tighten up the clamps when you first get the paddles, and that's something that you do with pretty much all sort of inflatable paddleboard packages with three-piece paddles. And then you can get a fairly tight locking paddle. This paddle is slightly different from other paddles in the market. It has a hollow handle at the top, keeps the weight down. It's quite comfy. It's got quite a tactile finish. Again, some people might not like the shape of it because it's quite dramatic. We found it absolutely fine, but it is quite neat having that hole in the middle. Again, keeps the weight down of the whole paddle. Next, before you get on the water, you're going to have to install your fin. This year, instead of having a 2+1 fin setup, which is where you have two side fins and one central bigger fin, they've gone for a single central fin, which is a really good move when you're touring. You've got less drag because you've taken the two side fins out. Because remember, the more fins you have, the straighter line you'll go in, but the more drag you'll have as well, so the slower you're going to be paddling. The central single swept back touring shape fin. We've seen this fin in lots of other packages, this style and shape. It's a great all-round touring fin, nice and wide at the base and nicely swept back. So it's easy to paddle, get you in a straight line, and it gives you a bit more stability as well, because fins will actually give you more stability. The wider the fin is, the more stability you will get. So if you're using a small base fin and you want a bit more stability on your board, go for a wider fin. It will make a difference. Also, you've got to install your leash, which clips around the leashing point at the back there. The Thurso leashes are really nice this year. They look much smarter. The inside of the leashes are sort of finished off with a nice grippy finish. The nice thing about having a coiled leash is it stays out of the water, so you're not going to slow yourself down catching any seaweed and obviously getting any debris on the leash. So having a coiled leash is a really nice move, and it's a nice quality, good looking coiled leash that matches the board well. So when it comes to moving the Thurso Surf Expedition Touring SUP onto the water, you've got a number of things which I say are much better than last year. One, the board's way lighter. You've still got all of the fittings, you've still got the paddle grip so you can put your paddle on the side, you've still got carry straps attachments here, you've still got large bungees, they've got handles at the front and back, GoPro mounts at the front. There's loads of stuff on this board that will put the weight up on the board. Anything you put on an iSUP, obviously you're going to put your weight up, but they've managed to keep the core board down in weight. They've done a lot more to the construction of the board this year. They're working with woven technology. It's a lighter base drop stitch, so they've really worked on the core materials, which we are really happy about, because it was the biggest complaint last year. The boards were heavy. Great quality, good stiffness. They have fixed them completely with this board, and it's really nice to see a fairly big board that's fairly lightweight. Like always, we sometimes mention, if you've got shorter arms or you're a smaller paddler, carrying a 6-inch thick board down to the water will stick out from your arm a little bit more, so it might be a little bit more uncomfortable for the shorter arm people. If you need help carrying it down to the water's edge, you have got handles at the front and back, which from a touring sense is absolute golden. You need to have that, especially if the board is loaded up, because you're not going to be able to carry it on its side with a central handle if you've got 25 kilograms of weight under the front bungees. When you go to get on the water and start standing around the standing area, you'll notice the really cool deck pad this year. Thurso have always had smart looking boards. The styling, like how the Expedition over here is cut into the EVA, it's not just printed on, it's all part of the EVA foam. The nice badge here, the arrows at the back there, they've got a small tail kick pad at the back if you want to start doing transitions and knowing where your back foot is and maybe doing step back turns and maneuvers like that. It's just a lot of classy looking finish on this board, and you definitely can feel it under your feet. A really nice looking pattern, and I personally really like the colorways of this board as well, but that's always a personal thing. Still got your sort of fake wood effect up here, which to be honest does look better in real life than I think it does in the pictures, and it's nice to see a full big tie down bungee up at the front there. They still had fairly big tie downs last year, and it really makes a difference to getting a decent sized dry bag up on the front of the board. They've got a small tie down at the back of the board there. That's really just for putting maybe a drink, your flip flops, a small dry bag, maybe clipping on your phone or that sort of stuff. It's not going to be something you're going to put a lot on there, but to be honest, this big one at the front makes up for that smaller one at the back. And you can access the bungees and a dry bag at the front here very easily because it's positioned quite close to your feet and standing area, which is another good move. When you go to stand up and paddle on this board, because of the board specifications at 11'6" long and 30 inches wide, you're gonna find it's got a lot of glide. It's gonna move through the water fairly easily and for the paddle strokes you put in, especially with the carbon shafted paddle. So you're gonna get a lot of glide for every paddle stroke you do, way more than you would do if you were paddling a 31 or 32 inch wide board. That nice big central fin is easy to paddle in a straight line. It's got a nice sort of hydrodynamic US fin box it all clips into, so it really does offer you quite an efficient paddling experience. It's definitely the sort of board that would lend itself to a first-time paddler if you're lighter, because of that easy glide. It's going to get you going in those straighter lines. The downside to having a longer base board is it makes the turns a little bit harder. It means you have to basically step back on the board to get the board to turn, or you have to do a slower base turn. But to be honest, if you're looking at this type of board, you're really looking to paddle that little bit further to have that ease of glide. So that's not really a downside. That's just something to consider when you're looking at any longer base board. So this board at 11'6" long really does have that nice, smooth glide, easy paddle nature. If we talk about how stiff this board was, or its deflection test, which is where we put this board on a gap of 1.5 meters apart and we put 75 kilograms of weight on the center of the board, and then we measure how much the board bends or deflects. Now, the board takes a recommended PSI of 12 to 15 PSI with a maximum PSI of 20. There's also a carbon enhanced rail down the side of the board, which is gonna give that board that more stiffness. And that internal drop stitch, that new woven technology, is all helping the board be stiffer than the previous years. Now, we tested this with two tests. We did it at 15 psi and 18 psi. At 15 psi, it dropped 14 millimeters, which is way stiffer than last year's previous water walker board when we tested it. And at 18 psi, it dropped 13 millimeters. So it shows you how much more air you put in the board will give you a stiffer base board. And obviously a stiffer board is a more efficient board, which is gonna allow you to paddle further, and it's gonna allow you to basically just have a better paddling experience. But remember, if you're a lighter paddler, 65, 70 kilos, you might not really need to go up to that 18 PSI to really feel a difference and to get that performance gain with having that higher pressure. But if you are a heavier rider, 95 kilos, you really are gonna see a better performance gain getting that extra air in a board. I think the general outline shape of this board and the rocker line shape of this board is really set up for all types of water paddling. So you're gonna be able to paddle it in open seas, you can paddle it on flat water. Just remember, the flatter the board overall, the faster the board is gonna be the paddle. But the harder it's gonna be able to paddle in choppier waters because the nose is gonna be diving. So this has got a nice little bit of nose rocker there that can just pop you over any chop, especially if you're weighing it down in the front with a bigger, heavier dry bag. So lots of open water conditions, this board will be happy. So looking at ability range, the weight range of paddler and what you could use it for, well, you're gonna see there's a lot of stuff you could use this board for. You could get into paddleboarding as a first-time paddleboarder. If you wanted to know, you wanted to sort of paddle and you wanted to do longer paddles and you wanted to do cruising paddles, wildlife paddles, touring paddles, if you're getting into the sport and you think, I want to do that sort of stuff, that's the sort of stuff which I'm looking at doing, then this sort of board could be right for you, especially if you are weighing first-time paddleboarders up to 80 kilograms, 75 kilograms, you won't find it too hard to start on a board of this width. If you are a bit heavier than that, you want a bit more confidence first, probably look at a board a little bit wider. If you are coming into this and you're wanting a touring base board, cruising, faster cruising board, and you already are a paddleboarder, maybe you've already got a paddleboard, this board will probably take you weight-wise up to about 110, 115 kilos if you're quite experienced. It's got the volume there, it will take you, it's got the stiffness. Remember, the narrower you go anyway, the faster your board will paddle. So you will get a performance gain by going with that narrower board. I think the real sweet spot for these boards for most people will be around 75 to 95 kilograms. A lot of you are going to enjoy paddling this board. And again, you're going to be taking it a little bit further. You're going to be paddling around the corner. You're going to be getting into SUP Expedition, light touring. It's, especially if you want to search out those more secluded spots around the the corner, around the next river bend, this sort of board is going to be great for that. When your paddling journey is all done, the nice thing about this board is it's really easy to deflate. You can just undo the back valve and you can just roll it up around the pump towards the tail and all the air just comes out. You haven't got to suck the air out or anything like that. It's very quick and easy to deflate. This year, again, they've improved the bags. They've made the bags bigger for the bigger boards. That really does make a difference, especially after a long day's paddling. So now let's talk a bit about the brand, the warranty, the environmental credentials of the brand, the pros and cons, and finishing off giving you a summary. So Thurso Surf have been making paddleboards for quite a few years, as I've said. They've got quite a few boards in the range. They do offer a 30-day complete money-back guarantee if you don't like the product, and they do give you a 2-year warranty as standard with all of their boards as well. Unfortunately, this one, when we got it, was still wrapped in plastic. I know Thurso are looking to change that, and maybe we got an early production one, and the newer ones will be coming in paper. But we look forward to seeing these boards wrapped in paper and cardboard, getting rid of all of the plastic. We're going to say that with every single brand until you all start wrapping them in paper. So very much, it's much easier to biodegrade, to recycle paper than it is obviously for plastic. But you can see Thurso Surf are moving towards that better recyclable materials on their products and wrapped in their products. I mean, their information packs all printed on recyclable paper. It's nice to see that just small things do make a difference, and I think that will be filtering out through the rest of the range very soon. We definitely hope so. Looking at pros and cons and some value for money, well, definitely the pros are there's been some really big improvements this year compared to last year's boards. Last year's boards were great and we did like them. The downsides to last year's boards was the weights, and they're quite heavy based boards. Thurso Surf have answered all of those problems that we complained about last year, and they have made a much stiffer, lighter base board, still loads of fitting, still really good value, so we'll bring value for money in there. So they have done a lot to really improve their products from last year. In fact, there's so many more improvements. As far as cons are concerned, it's very hard to actually really come out without any big negatives to these boards. Maybe we want them to be lighter again, but to be totally honest, I wouldn't say you're going to get them any lighter with the amount of fixtures and sort of fittings you've got on these boards. Handles at the front and back really make a difference. So this year, the pros and cons, they really are poles apart. The pros, there's loads of pros: the weights, constructions, the fittings, the boards, the fins. Taking the side fins off made a big difference, I think, for the touring boards. Lots of really good pros that we really like. Cons, I'm not really going to give you any cons on this, because I think overall it's a good package and it sits a very competitive price point. So I really hope you found that review interesting and informative. The Thurso Surf Expedition Touring Board 138 is a board that a lot of you are going to be looking at and should be looking at. Whether you're getting into paddleboarding the first time, you're a little bit lighter but you know you want to paddle that bit further, or you are looking for a better, stiffer, lighter touring SUP to take you that much further. If you have any comments, questions, have you got this board? Have you had good, bad experiences with Thurso Surf? Please get them in the comments below. Check out our SUPboarder Mag website if you haven't been on that already. Give this video a like if you found it useful. Give this video a dislike if you found it complete rubbish, but please write in the comment section below why you found it rubbish so we can improve from it for the future. Thank you very much, and we'll see you next time.